Hello and welcome to the Average Joe Movie Show. I'm your host, Mark Stern, joined by my three cohorts here. Jay Cottrell, former All-Pro linebacker. How you doing? We've got star of stage and screen, Will Lash, and of course, former welterweight lap dancer, Pat Linnell.
Yeah.
Yes. So thank you guys for being here with us, obviously. It's great fun. We are the Average Joe Movie Show. And just to give you an idea of what the show is all about, look, we understand we're not professional critics. We are not theater critics or art critics. But what we do know is what a good movie is and what a crappy movie is. And we're here to tell you what the difference is. Because we know that movies cost a lot of money, cost a lot of time these days, and we want to save you both time and money from going to see a crappy movie. Now, first up, we've got the movie Precious, that was based on the novel by Sapphire, starring Gabourey Sidibe, among many others. Monique also in this, some few turns by Mariah Carey, and also by Lenny Kravitz. This story tells the story of 16-year-old Clarice Precious Jones, who grew up in Harlem in the 1980s. She spent her whole life being abused physically and mentally by her parents, including being raped by her father and impregnated twice. So really tough movie, but it is inspiring in a lot of different ways. So, with Precious, starring Gabourey Sidibe. By the way, that was her first role that she's ever had. This is her acting debut, and it's creating a lot of buzz, guys. I mean, it's got three Golden Globes. She's been nominated for Best Actress, the Golden Globes and SAG. Monique, who plays her mother, which might be one of the most awful human beings you've ever seen in your life, also gets nominations. Let's start off with you, Jay. What do you have to say about this movie?
I could not recommend this movie to anyone. After watching it, I wanted to put a bullet in my head because it was the most depressing movie I've ever seen in my life. Nothing good happened at the end. She got AIDS, and then we were left like going, what's going to happen next?
Okay, so this is not what you would call.
Well, not let me ask what you. I call an uplifting
well,
film.
That's right, yeah,
it's
not exactly.
Not taken away.
Not to feel good.
The question is, should people see it, though?
Yeah, Pat, what do you think?
Here's my deal. You're not going to want to see this movie, but you should see this movie because it's real. You know, we go to movies because they suspend us from reality, being all caught up and hyped up and whatnot. But when you sit down and see Precious, you think, man, this is real life. And it's not fun, but we should
see. But do you want to see real life for two? Not that real.
Yeah, well.
Not that real.
I mean, but the story had to be told. And, you know, and just like the book. I mean, I don't think that Tyler Perry or Oprah would have taken the opportunity to put this story out there if they didn't think that people needed to hear it. I think definitely people needed to see the story. And as depressing and as disturbing as it was, and believe me, I think I can pretty much watch anything.
Jay, sure. Are you not an Oprah fan? Is that?
Now I hate to admit one reason that going into this movie, I was like, oh, I'm gonna hate this when I heard Tyler Perry's name attached.
What's
to
wrong
it.
With Tyler Perry, man?
Should I start with Meet the Browns? What?
Hilarious.
Where do you want me to start? Yeah, right. I'm waiting for a good Tyler Perry movie.
All right, yeah. But you know, let's take another movie that was tough to watch, Schindler's List. Okay, that's a tough movie. It's a tough topic, yeah. But it was still a great movie.
Right. And a true story.
And a true story. Now, you're not. I mean, I understand you not maybe think it was difficult. Topic to watch. I mean, incest is not exactly something you're like, hey, let's get the kids to go watch this movie.
I expected something like The Color Purple, which that was a tough movie to watch too.
Sure.
But at least at the end, it was like, okay, she opened up her own store.
See, now I just
not every story has a happy ending.
But I don't know if anyone should see it. I didn't want to see it. I sat there and I wanted to go. I gotta leave the theater now because nothing worse can happen to her. And then boom, something else would happen.
I love you, man, but I don't know. Yeah. I think it's a little harsh there.
Yeah. I can see if it was senseless. Like, I remember the first time I saw Natural Born Killers. That was senseless.
But wasn't that a true story, too?
Based on a true story.
You know,
but this was, I think this was, like I said, it was a story that people needed to hear. And, you know, it gives you an understanding as to why things happen to people not because of any fault of their own. You know, things just happen and people grow up that way and it's unfortunate, but it's life.
And she did throughout the movie. You saw these glimpses. It's a brilliant performance by Gabourey Sidibe. I mean, coming off the street.
Is that just Oscar worthy, though?
I think the Oscar's going to love her.
I don't know if it was Oscar.
Yes, I think Monique was.
I want you to tell me what an Oscar worthy, and just played the meanest character ever on the screen.
Which I think is a lot like Monique. I don't really think she was the straight.
Actually, no.
If that's a lot like Monique, she's got some issues.
She didn't share her ledger with, I thought, you know, she probably doesn't.
But by the way, can we also say, when we saw Mariah Carey with no makeup, did everybody go, Nick Cannon, oh my God? Did everybody, because I know I did.
I think it made a lot of sense as to why they're together.
I thought she was brilliant. I didn't even recognize her. She plays the social worker that Gabrielle Sabatier has to go see, and she has this mustache, and I couldn't even take my eyes off the mustache. It was such a realistic little detail. I found it to be fascinating. I'm like, who is that? That's great.
That's what happens when women don't wax, man. You know what I'm saying? That's real, too.
That's real life.
Important
that's
safety.
Real life.
Important safety.
When you're a social worker making $24,000 a year, that's real life.
You don't have time to wax the lip.
Yeah, all
right.
But that's for Oscar buzz. I mean, I don't get that. I was actually just so into it and just so disturbed by it that I honestly just wasn't really paying attention to the acting. Like, I was just so
caught up in the story.
Like, sure. I really wasn't paying attention as to whether or not, which is probably a good thing, which, you know, maybe that, you know.
Well, there you go. All right, well, Jay, what about this movie? What do you give it?
Would I tell people to go see it? I would tell people about it, but I couldn't recommend it because I was just so shocked by it.
Okay. Will?
I'd say it's definitely, and now I wouldn't take my children to go see it necessarily.
Unless you want to threaten them.
Unless, yeah.
See, this is what it could be like.
We'd have to sit down for a long time. I don't have kids, but if I had, I mean, my nieces and nephews, but
right.
You know, there was definitely a long conversation after this. But I think it's definitely a movie to see, whether, you know, you don't necessarily have to go to the big screen, but, you know, it's a renter.
Pat? Yeah,
ditto that, man. You're stealing my notes because I think people need to see this film, but not in the theater.
Well, there you go. A couple of positive views for it and one negative from my man Jay here. When we come back, we're going to give you all the latest news from Hollywood with Karen Sows. The Average Joe Movie Show continues